Yo, I have a promise to everyone who's been constantly asking me and requesting for me to get back on the Mental Jewels series. I promise you that I will start doing them very, very consistently, okay? So we can start today with the first one of many. Like I said, I'm gonna try to be consistent with you guys with this, okay? Because I really enjoy doing the Mental Jewels. And here at the Ambrosia Collective, we pride ourselves on not just pushing supplements and products, but also pushing, not pushing, but sharing perspective, life hacks, different things that we picked up along the way to help you, us have, you know, a better life. So I'm gonna share tactics with you guys from all around the world, and you guys can take away what you wanna take away from it, all right? So we're gonna talk about blue zones today, all right? And I wanna start out with a story from Greece, like ancient Greeks. The ancient Greeks were actually pretty fucking savage. You all know that. But there's one guy I wanna talk about in particular, and his name was Tithonus. Okay, he was a prince of Troy, and he fell in love with the goddess of the dawn. Her name was Eos. Now, Eos asked her father, who happened to be Zeus, to make Tithonus immortal, and he did. But Zeus did some cynical dad shit that I'd probably do. He made him immortal, but he did not give him eternal youth. So basically, Tithonus aged for all of eternity. He's still aging right now. That's crazy. But, you know, Zeus, that's kind of fucked up. Like, for real, bro, why would you do that? Anyway, people talk about how life expectancy is greater now than it was 80 or 100 years ago. Well, the reason for that is modern technology. I don't see it as we're living longer. It's just that technology and modern medicine allows us to die longer, stay sick, and hold on for longer. And in my opinion, that's not living. We gotta shift our minds from quantity to quality and living gracefully. Well, anyway, while researching all of this, I found someone who actually did what I'm talking about. It's an explorer with National Geographic. His name is Dan Buettner. In 2004, Buettner looked at census data from around the world. He found five places that were really, really high populations of centenarians. No, not centaurs, centenarians. These are people who live well past 100 years old and are still healthy, vibrant, full of energy, etc. Now, the five areas are Okinawa, Japan, Sardinia, Italy, Nicoya Peninsula, Costa Rica, Icaria, Greece, and right down the street in Loma Linda, California. Now, in the United States, there's 1.73 centenarians for every 10,000 people. But in these five areas, there's about 6.5 centenarians for every 10,000 people. That's crazy. So Buettner spent 5 years traveling to each of these locations. He was absorbing the culture, meeting the people, learning their lifestyles, habits, and eating their foods. He called these areas blue zones. I'm not going to get into all the specifics on his research of these places, but there's certain things that they all had in common. The people only ate whole foods, lots of vegetables, healthy fats, and they seldomly had animal protein. For instance, in Okinawa, meat is reserved for occasional ceremonial events. They do things like plant medical gardens, where they have mugwort, ginger, and turmeric. These are staples in an Okinawa garden. They were very active. They got plenty of vitamin D from being in the sun all day. They did things to mitigate stress, like forming these dope collectives and social networks to where they looked out for each other in times of need. In Okinawa, they called it moai. What Moai is an actual secure social network where they gave each other financial and emotional support. Now, there's a lot to take away from that. Instead of like we living like it's every man to himself and only looking out for yourself, looking out for your neighbors and your friends will have them also looking out for you. And in turn, it will reduce stress when situations arise that would typically stress you out. And stress can be a killer. So anyway, here's some tactics that we can apply from these blue zones into our own lives. Tactic one, setting up your kitchen for long life. There's small tricks that Buettner noticed in the kitchens of centenarians. They put fruits and vegetables on the top shelves of the refrigerator. They own smaller dinner plates, less than 10 inches in diameter. They drink out of tall, skinny glasses. They use hand-operated kitchen appliances for opening cans and processing food. And there was no TVs in the kitchen. These were small things that reduced the amount of food that they ate strengthen their hands, arms, and encourage healthy, longevity-focused eating. They were eating to live, not living to eat. All right, tactic two, build your purpose. Please excuse my pronunciation, but the Okinawans called it ikigai. I hope I'm saying it right, ikigai. The Costa Ricans called it plan de vida. Buettner and his team conducted an NIH-funded study that looked at people from the age of 65 to 92. They found that these people live up to 9 years longer when they know they have a purpose and a reason for getting up in the morning. Finding your why to life can actually prevent disease and can give you more healthy years. It just gives you more meaning and more purpose for living. All right, anyway, tactic three, the right people. We talked about the benefits of having a community of people that you care about. This can be your church, workout partners, study group, your PlayStation homies, basically anybody with similar interests, whatever it is. Keep people around you who care about you. And if you can't do that, if you're so weird that you ain't got no friends, just get yourself a cat or a dog, all right? Having people around that show you love can add years to your life and really benefit your brain. Anyway, that's all I have for you today. This was completely brought to you by the Ambrosia Collective. This is what I want you to do though. I want you to click the link below and just take a look at the products. I mean, click through the ingredients that we use. I really want you to read for yourself to see how effective they are. I'm so proud of what we have and our team here at the Ambrosia Collective. I'm also growing the collective. I'm looking for like-minded ambassadors that want to spread quality products and quality tactics and life hacks that will help people live happier and more graceful lives. If that fits you, click on the second link down below and let's begin the process. Until then, I'm out.